Welcome to my favourite time of the month. It's that time to show you what I think are the best, the top 10 albums from the month of May. Now, May has been a glorious month. So many big names, so many big releases, and we only have space for 10. So, with that being said, put in the comments below before I start the video, what's your favourite album from May? What's your least favourite album from May as well? Because, you know, sometimes it's even more fun to tell me why you think something is shit. So pop that in the comments below, and shall we just get started into the list? Let's fucking go. So coming in at number 10, we have Hyems with Anatomie Day Scheiterns. And I've definitely not said that fucking right, but all the names to the albums will be in the comments box below, so you can check them out at your own leisure. But let's give it a little listen. So this is one of the earlier albums from the month, and oh boy, it pounded my balls into mash. I fucking love it. It's like, you can tell that it's black metal. Just from what you heard, you know it's black metal, but it's so intense, so energetic, and it's fucking furious. It's furious black metal fun. Every single song hits you hard, and it doesn't do any limp punches. It fucking goes full in. And breaks your jaw. That's this fucking album. You know, actually, it's kind of like the cover. The cover art is very apt. It's pretty much like that when you listen to it. I mean, from that first fucking song, with that kind of marching drum beat, and then it just hits you, kind of like a war. It is kind of war-themed, this album, and yeah. I love how fast, how intense, how aggressive it is. And there will be more black metal on this list, just to let you know. But this is so much different to all the others, because this feels like a... You're going to war. It feels like you're going to war. Everything is at your side. The guns are loud. Everything's fucking loud. The explosions are happening everywhere. It's just, it's a rollercoaster ride. And I loved it when I first heard it. And I still love it. So, has to make my list. And it's going in number 10. Number 9, we have Unreqvited with Empathica. A lot different. So, let's give it a listen. Now this is the polar fucking opposite. The polar opposite of Hyems. You fast and infectious and furious. This is very mellow. Very relaxing. It's still black metal, but it's so relaxing. It's kind of like a black gaze kind of theme to the song. Kind of like Alcest. Which is maybe why I'm wearing the shirt. I love that kind of sound. And it delivers it so goddamn well. And it's not the only release these guys did this year. They released another album back in January, which is also perfect. But this one, to me, I don't know, just the melodies in it just sit right a little bit more. Just for me personally anyway. But from the album art, you know you're getting yourself into a relaxing, peaceful, zen-like album. And that's what you get. If that kind of black metal suits you, you will love this album just like I did. So definitely give it your time. Give it your fucking time and passion and patience. And also listen to it when you're going to bed because it's so relaxing. You will be off before you know it. And that's a good thing. You know, you want some relaxing music sometimes. And this goddamn delivers it. Number 8, we have a controversial one. You're all going to get fucking angry. Alestorm, Curse of the Crystal Coconut. Yeah, you probably know what it sounds like already, but let's give a listen anyway. So yeah, as this is so controversial, this being even on the list, I should probably pass it over to my colleague and, you know, he can do it instead of me, so yeah, fuck off.
Monkey! Tell the elitists to fuck off, Monkey! It's a fun album for fun monkeys!
Okay, so Monkey didn't really want to fucking talk, so I'll do you the honours. This album is the most fun I've had in the entire month of May. I'm a big Alestorm fan, I love all their albums. I've seen a lot of reviews online. You know who you are. And they trash it for saying it's more of the same. But if you know, you listen to all the other Alestorm albums, this is not more of the fucking same. Have you listened to this fucking album? Wooden Leg Part 2 is a crazy symphonic metal epic 8-minute long song sequel to Wooden Leg Part 1, which is also fucking awesome. It includes singing from fucking Japanese folk metal, the band, which are also fun as fuck. It has fucking Spanish singing in. You've got Zombie Ate My Pirate Ship, which has female vocals as this, like, 5-minute mid-range ballady song, which they've never really fucking done before. They've never done anything like Wooden Leg Part 2 before, either. You have Chomp Chomp, which is a more folk metal themed song, with singer from Fintroll in, and that sounds nothing like anything Alestorm's ever fucking done. Then you have Tortuga, which is kind of, has got fucking rap in it, and you say this album's more of the same? Are you fucking insane? Are you fucking insane? This does not sound like any other Alestorm album. And for that, some people might not like it. You know, it's a bit wacky, it's a bit crazy, it's not like usual pirate metal, which is a lot of the complaints I'm seeing. But the other complaints where it's like more of the same, that fuck off. Yeah. I say that nicely. Now, for people who aren't a fan of Alestorm, you already know you don't like the band, so, you know, this isn't going to sell you. This album isn't going to sell you. And for people who want the usual pirate metal stuff, this album isn't going to sell you really either. This is something fresh, something new, and for me, it worked because I love stupid shit and I love drinking and having fun. I've seen Alestorm live 100 times, so I adored it. I keep playing it. I got Zombies Ate My Pirate Ship stuck in my head. Stuck in my fucking head. Yeah, rant and rambling aside, this is all done in jest, by the way. I don't have no hard feelings to fucking anyone. I love all the reviewers out there. I just, you know, this is just in jest. But I fucking love the album. So it's going on my list. Going on my list right fucking here. 7, we have Forgotten Tomb with Nihlistic Estrangement. Let's listen. So this is a very strange mix of kind of black and doom. I would probably say black and doom is the genre for this one. Because when you first listen to this album, you're like, where's the doom elements? But when it gets later into the album, you can really hear the doom elements shine through. Especially on the fucking title track. Holy shit, that's doomy as hell and one of my favourite songs from the month of May. There's so many just interesting songs on this album. Active Shooter is a really fun and energetic song from the album, and then, like I said, the title track is very slow, very brooding, very moody, and it sets up the mood of the album quite nice. And then one of my favourites, Distrust Cubed, is another fun, funky song. So this album has everything. Forgotten Tomb is an awesome goddamn band, and this album just continues to elevate them to stardom. So yeah, fucking love this album. Next up, another weird placement on my list. I never would have thought metalcore would be on my top 10 of May. But alas, here it is. Bleed From Within, Fracture. Let's listen. This is not a war, it's a victory. I looked into the eyes of misery. Cover up the truth, spread hypocrisy. From nothing you came, went into nothing you return. So I recently talked about this on one of my recent videos, and yeah, I fucking adore it. I love it. The melodies, the hooks, the breakdowns, everything is fucking on point. This is what metalcore should sound like. If all metalcore bands sounded like this, well, it'd be kind of boring if they all sounded the same, but if more metalcore bands sounded aggressive and had the edge like Bleed From Within and Parkway does, I'd love them a hell of a lot fucking more. A lot of them kind of fall into the same trap of they're just kind of meh. They're just kind of in the middle. It's like, eh. This is high octane fun, and I love it for that. It has that thrashy energy. It has that deathcore aggressiveness as well. It pains me to call it a metalcore band because it just seems like so much more. So many good fucking songs in here, like the title track. Into Nothing, which you all know is one of my favorites. I fucking adore that song. Just that breakdown when he says into nothing. Oh, it just fucking rips. It rips, it wrecks. And you need a new head after headbang into it. Love this album. It's going to be on repeat for a long time. Bleed From Within. Fucking did it again, boys. Did it again. Halfway point now. Hopefully you're still stuck in there. I hope you didn't run away when I did my Alestorm rant. But we got something a bit mellow, a bit calmer now for you. Paradise Lost, Obsidian. This is the culmination of all of Paradise Lost's works, fucking mixed together, fused together with that Yu-Gi-Oh card, whatever the fuck it was with the swirly shit. Not Karibo. Wait, you know what it is? Polymerization? Isn't that Harry Potter? Well, whatever it is. Fused together to make the perfect Paradise Lost album. It has elements from all the other albums in this album. It has all the fucking elements from the other. It's got gothic sounding shit, it's got death doom stuff, it's got regular doom stuff, kind of Sister of Mercy shit, it's everything they've been working up to, and it's the masterpiece in my opinion. So many good songs, so many catchy songs as well. And you can tell all this from the first song, Darker Thoughts, which just has like an acoustic opening, then it gets heavier and moodier, and then it just all explodes in the middle. Yeah, from the very first song, you're hooked. And then you got other classics like Fall From Grace, Ghosts and Raven Gas. Too many good songs in this album. It's one of the best Doom albums of the year, alongside Catatonia, if you can still consider Catatonia Doom. If not, this is the best. Just fucking is. So it's making it onto my list. Next up, we have AFSKY with an album title that we'll try and pronounce together. Okay, so Ofte Yeg Drømmer Migdod. I hope that's right, but I don't really care if it isn't. People will tell me anyway. It'll be in the comments so you can check it out at your own leisure. I knew this was going to be good when I first fucking saw the album art, and oh boy was it. But without me rambling about it, first, let's listen. So much emotion in this record, and it all comes through from the album cover. You know what you're getting yourself in for. A pain journey of intense black metal fun, you know? And the vocals do sound pained. It does feel like that's happening, that trauma is happening through the songs themselves. Again, this is a lot different to the other black metal we're talking about. It's not anything like the Empathica record. It's not anything. I'd probably say it's more like the Hyems record, but a lot less war themed, a lot less kind of I'm marching to war, more I'm dying from the plague. I'm dying from famine. Raiders have come to burn my hut down. It feels more like that. Like despair. Evil despair. I'm lost on this fucking farmland and I'm dying. It feels like that. All the songs are fucking fantastic. I'm not going to try and pronounce any of them again. It's just an amazing black metal journey. One of the best of the month. Number three, Winterfylleth. One of the most anticipated albums of the month. One of the albums I was so looking forward to. And ooh boy, I said, ooh boy, can I get a hell yeah? It fucking delivered. It delivered in spades, and let's listen. Yeah, this is more on the line of folky black metal, kind of similar to Sayor, but I heard Winterfylleth live, and they fucking knocked it out of the park. And I was like, holy shit, this band's fucking sick. So I listened to all the catalogue, and the catalogue is fucking sick. So I was so hyped for this new album to come out. I'm fairly new to Winterfylleth, but I was hyped for this to come out. It's one of my most anticipated, and it just knocked it out of the park. Every single song is a gem. Every single song has so much catchy melodies in. You know, if the other black metal isn't for you, if you're not really too big into black metal, I would say check out Winterfylleth. Check out The Reckoning Dawn. Check out The Reckoning Dawn. I don't know if I said that in the start, the name of the fucking album, but yeah, The Winterfylleth, The Reckoning Dawn. Give it a listen, because the melodies will grab you. Listen to that, and listen to Empathica's one, because that's just relaxing, and it's an easy listen. So I'd say listen to those two for the month of May, and maybe, you know, just maybe, you'll enjoy black metal. Top two, this is the hardest decision I've had to make. I love both these records, and I think they'll both be in my end of the year list. Number two is Odraza, Rzeczom. I think that's how you say it, Rzeczom. Let's just listen. I knew this album was gonna be flawless from the very first fucking song. When it starts out with that creepy kind of melody at the start, I was like, this feels like some evil Nightmare on Elm Street shit, like some kids playing some musical box and it's gonna jump out and rip the throat out. And that's what the album did to me. I was like, what's gonna happen? And then it hits you with that fucking black metal fury, and then it rips your throat out, and you're like, oh, and you can't speak anymore because you're trying to sing along, and it just doesn't work. It just doesn't fucking work. Polish black metal just can't get any better. I mean, there's so many good Polish black metal bands now, and Odraza is fucking one of them. And this album is a fucking masterpiece. 10 out of 10. One of my favourites of the fucking year. And it's 100% going in the end of the year list, because it floored me. Love everything about it. This is just one that you just have to listen for yourself. You just have to listen for yourself. I can't really describe how good it is until you listen to the entire thing, and that's what I implore you to do. Listen to the fucking thing, then tell me in the comments below. So that leaves us with my number one favorite album of May 2020, and this was a fucking surprise. Like, this was a real fucking surprise. It's not black metal. Yeah, it's not doom metal, I don't even know what kind of metal it is, but we are talking about Cryptic Shift, Visitations from Enceladus. Let's just listen to the mayhem. This is easily my favourite. As soon as I heard this record, I heard it again another like 3 times just to figure out what I was listening to. It is one of those strange, interesting albums that you just have to keep listening to and listening to. Like last month it was Ulcerate, I just have to keep listening to it to try and find more parts of the songs, and it's the same with this record. To best describe it, it's death metal, but it's on the more technical side, but without the whole technical wankery. It's a lot more ethereal. It's spacey death metal. I guess cosmic death metal, that's probably the way I'd describe it. But these songs, holy fuck, these songs. When you start off with like a 25-minute song, and it keeps you interested, and it goes so fucking fast. Like, the amount of sections in this song, and it goes so fucking fast. That's a testament to how good the songwriting is on this fucking album. Everything feels otherworldly. You feel like you're on a Saturn, or, you know, you're on Uranus, and you're just having a blast. You're having a blast in Uranus. It's great. It's a great time. Basically, on like simpler terms, to give you an idea what it sounds like, it's kind of like Vector with that space thrash theme, but take out the thrash and add death metal, and that's kind of what it would sound like. But they're selling it short because it is its own entity and it is fucking flawless. Every section in these songs are just insane. You know, you got beebity boobity alien noises throughout the first track, and it just fits so well with the death metal atmosphere. I don't know, it's hard to describe again, but I adore it. It's unique, it's creative, it's fun, and it's my favourite album of May, and it's probably going to be one of my favourite albums of the year. Probably front runner at the moment, so fucking awesome album. So let me know in the comments below your favourite albums from May, your least favourite albums. What do you think of my list? What would you change? Would you fucking drag Alestorm out to the back and shoot them in the back of the head? Look at the flowers. Look at the flowers. What would you do? Let me know, and we'll see you again on another Quest for Metal.